What you got there?
What?
What you got there?
I got my doom step.
Your doom step?
I got my doom step.
Your step of doom.
My step of doom. My wooden step of doom. What you got there?
Got my doom back.
You got your doom back?
My doom.
I got your doom back too.
You do?
I do. Why are we talking like this?
I don't know.
We weren't even watching them. I had no sensors in it. Them show people got down and yanked as you hit.
So, welcome Wednesday. It's the 15-4 challenge. We hope you guys have been practicing or following or tapping or something. As you know, the 15-4 challenge is just that. We're challenging you guys to learn something new. I'm practicing 4 days a week, doing 15 minutes a day of whatever it is that you want to learn. We want to learn more about the Doumbek, and that's what we're doing. So, you ready?
Yeah.
We're going to start out with paradiddles. Hey, Mark.
Hey.
Ready?
Why are you laughing?
Because I was too. First thing you do is you put your wrist on your drum, and then you tuck your fingers.
Starting with my ring finger?
Starting with, yeah. I was trying to remember it was. But the key is that your wrist is on the drum, to give you a chance to a place to push off on.
Well, like this part of my wrist?
Your flat part.
Right here?
No, this part.
Right. Be able to do it, but that's it. Your rest, you gotta put your rest on there. Well, not like that. I'm gonna do it so good one day.
Okay. So now we will work on our finger isolation.
Isolation. No, we're gonna do.
Just mechanics, there has to be some artistry to it as well. It's like there's a difference between someone who can play guitar and somebody who can play guitar well. No, I'm not saying that at all. I'm saying there's a difference between the mechanics of it. Right now we were learning the mechanics of it. Now you have to put a little finesse into it.
I can't do it at all yet.
Uh-huh. That's what we're practicing.
Okay. What is it that you think I'm not doing?
Well, I think you're concentrating on getting that when it's, I think you need to open up the spaces a little bit between each finger movement.
How can I open up the spaces if we're going that fast?
Can you do that?
Yes, I can do that.
So I think what we're looking for is consistency in a metronome type of way of each stroke at the same interspersement, I guess would be the word.
How am I supposed to do that?
I don't know, this is one of the things where it's hard to find the missing link between and, you know what I mean? Because at some point, it kind of has to become like that. That's better. That's a lot better.
But the problem is that going from this to this. Hold on. I'm not sure I can articulate this correctly. The problem that I can sit here, I can do this all day. I can do this all day long, right? Probably because I sit there and do that when I'm doing nothing. But the mechanics of doing it from this and then thinking about this and now thinking that this is like this, because I'm thinking about all this other stuff, it's no longer the natural doing it, so having to put this other stuff, I can't articulate.
Couple of things that I've learned in Doumbek playing is you almost have to get to a point and you have to just stop thinking about it. In the beginning, you have to think about it all the time. You're trying to make
sure
it hits.
Well, I am in the beginning.
Yeah. But there comes a point where it becomes necessary to literally to think less about it and allow your fingers to do what you want them to do by just telling them that.
That won't work because I've only been playing Doumbek for like 3 weeks. So my body has...
But you're a good student. I'm putting my finger in your ear. The other thing is, this is slightly longer than a single hit.
Yeah.
So when you're doing this, it feels more like a single hit than when you do this. Does that make sense?
No.
Well, let's keep practicing.
That's like, can you not do this one, that the extra talk? Can you just do... That?
Hello.
snotty. I get a little snotty from time to time. If you know me, you probably know that.
Time to time to time.
What?
Time to time to time. You'll find that the left hand, you're probably going to have to do, we're going to have to work more on the, this, or the non-dominant hand is obviously far behind the dominant hand as far as dexterity.
I know that. I know that. No, that's not what we were doing with the other hand. You're not putting a space between the doom and the finger roll. Mm-hmm.
And do the left hand.
Do a very slow down. We're slowing it down, there's going to be a space, a longer space. I think we should just do the isolations. Can you hear?
Well, just building up the muscle. It's important to be able to put those together.
I think that we should just do the isolations. Can we do a flower?
Saidi. Little open Saidi. Ready? Thursday, and if that's Friday, just in case you were wanting to know, I don't know why.
Today's Wednesday.
Yeah.
Is that what you started with?
Yep.
Why'd you say that?
So, hey, thanks for hanging out with us. We hope you've been practicing. We hope you continue to practice. We hope you check out our videos on cooking and drumming and music and mythology and Sims. And we hope you check out our website and look at our tie-dye t-shirts and our bell belts. And our graphic design t-shirts, as well as our CDs, all of which you can be part of our family. See you tomorrow.
Bye. Oh, you did like a little skip.
No, no.
Let's see.